I'm not sure if you've heard, but there's this thing going on called, Two Alive, and it has a story by Neil Dickinson, and it was written by Devin Garman. So we'll see how it goes.
Doing? Get up! You were supposed to have the house spotless before your mother and I got back from the movie. Part of being spotless means you need to sweep the floors, mop the floors, buffer the floors, wax the floors, and vacuum the carpets. And what is this? I come home to find you itching your worms like a dog on my custom-ordered Biscavi rug, imported from Russia. For Christ's sakes, you mutt, get up! You also forgot that today is Saturday, which means you need to trim the bushes, mow the lawn, clean the pool, and clean up any doo-doo my precious Mr. Snuffles has left behind, which of whom is probably dying from missing his mummy so much. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must go tend to Mr. Snuffles. I can't afford to lose anyone else close to me because of your ignorance.
How much longer do I have to make it through this?
Make it through what?
Her, your sister-in-law, Sharon. You let her treat me like I'm her own little maid. I'm always cleaning up after her and that damn dog, Mr. Snuffles. And then on top of every little thing that I do here, she never lets me live the accident down. She acts like she was the only one affected by Dad's death.
Well, your father's death was especially hard on her, Michael. The two of them were very close.
See, there you go defending her again. You always do this. I mean, I am his son, you know.
Look, Michael, I really don't have time for this right now. Your brothers won their big game today, and I have to get a cake in the oven before they get home. Just finish whatever Aunt Sharon needs help with today.
Fine. Walk out on me now, but just remember, you can't run away from your problems. I'll just be here, waiting for you to get back. Who's there?
How does it feel to be the Cinderella of the family? Be slave and bound to around Sharon at her every whim while she badgers you about your father? How is she to know how you actually feel?
I don't know. I guess she can't. Who? What am I talking
well,
about?
Well, I know, Mr. Prison. I know exactly how you feel.
Okay, this isn't funny anymore, James. Where are you? Hunter, is that you?
There's no one here but you and I, Hunter.
Oh my God. Am I losing my mind?
No, of course not. Well, kind of actually, but don't think of it as those terms. Think of it as gaining a new perspective or an improved outlook or maybe a mistake. Besides, I'm so glad about the mind you had anyway.
Had? I don't believe this. This isn't happening. I must be severely sleep deprived, and I need a nap. How is this happening?
Well, it's really quite simple, young man. You see?
Who are you talking to?
No one really. Just myself.
Are you okay, hon?
Yeah, I guess so. Why do you ask?
It's just, I worry about you sometimes. Worry about you a lot, actually. You've been acting distant lately. I guess that's why I'm asking.
Is that what you're calling it now? You think I'm distant? Did I not just tell you about 5 minutes ago, and every day before that, for the past 8 years, we've lived in this hellhole you chose to raise us in? I'm treated so poorly by Aunt Sharon, and you know it. It's like I'm a freaking Cinderella or something. I can't handle it.
It's nonsense. You've got your mind wrapped around it all the wrong way.
Well, what other way is there to see it? It's quite possible that woman could be the devil.
Honey, that's impossible. You know she goes to church every Sunday.
Well, going to church doesn't make you any more Christian than standing in a garage makes you a car.
Michael, there's no other way for you to see it. Aunt Sharon is just getting old. She needs a little more help around the house than usual. I'm sure that's not too much to ask for.
Okay. Well, what about James and Hunter? They're just as able-bodied as I am to do anything. And yet it's me that's always working. And how do you explain Aunt Sharon's constant bedeviling? She never lets up about Dad. Every day she's able to produce new heinous comments from out of nothing, and then deal them out like cards.
I know not everything that comes out of her mouth is nice, but it's not necessarily true either. Remember how I've told you time and time before your aunt and father were closer than most siblings?
Yes, I know, but...
Obviously you don't fully understand it though, Michael. Imagine yourself in her shoes, losing both your parents at the age of 7 in a no-survivor collision.
It sounds just as bad as what happened to me. Imagine killing your own father, and you don't see me treating others like shit for it.
Michael, mind your language. I know you've had it bad as well, but better than she did. At least you have other family around to take care of you, like me and your brothers. Her and your father were alone, looking out for each other. Now she fills that gap by taking care of your brothers. And I'm sorry to say it, Michael, but I'm saving you a lot of time and pain. You need to face the facts. Your accident was the icing on the cake for her. Aunt Sharon may not admit it, but she still hasn't fully accepted your father's death. She's no outlet and she won't let anyone in either. We're just going to have to make do.
Make do? I've been making do for almost 8 years now, and anything is yet to change. I don't know how much longer I can last here.
What is that supposed to mean?
I can't live here anymore. Something has to change.
Well, if you're so set about this change, then what do you suppose we do?
We can move out. Find a small apartment or trailer home at least. Anywhere that's not here.
Where do you think we're going to get the money for that? You know I can't support you and your brothers with my job alone. We need your aunt, Michael. Please be grateful she's here for us.
Oh, she's here for you guys. She could care less
about...
Don't
say it, Michael!
You know it's true. Look, I've already found a few jobs in the newspaper. I've given some of them a call and they sound pretty promising. I think if at least I can get a job, then we'll be able to afford the payment. And then maybe if we can convince James and Hunter to actually do something for once, they can get jobs too and we'll be even better off.
Like that'll ever happen.
It's at least worth a try.
Michael, there's more to this than you think you know. Nothing's going to change. We're just going to keep living here with Aunt Sharon. I don't want to hear another word about it.
Some people are just too things through. But not me, Michael. I don't have that block. I believe in you. This is no place for a young man to live, where he's constantly reminded of his own self-inflicted misfortune. They're the ones who don't understand.
You're right. How could they understand? They have no idea what it's like to know that you're living with the burden of killing your own father.
Talk to me, Michael. I'm here for you. How does it feel?
It feels horrible. Like I don't deserve to live. Images of my father lying in his own pool of blood keep me up every night as I relive the incident over and over and over again. And even when I'm finally able to drift off to sleep, it doesn't end there. Nightmares have plagued all my dreams. I wake up night after night to my own screams to find myself lying in a cold sweat. I know it sounds ridiculous.
Not the slightest. You endured one of the most atrocious things any one boy could face in his life, Michael. The act of patricide, killing one's father, it's only normal to resist a few side effects.
Side effects?
Oh, you know.
Severe depression. Suicide. Hallucinations. Those types of things.
I don't really think I have any of those.
Then how do you explain me, Michael?
Well, do you have a name?
A few, actually. Some call me their imaginary friend or the voice in their head. Well, the men in white coats call me Id. But I think Ed's a little more formal, don't you think?
And it is, then.
Now that we know each other a little bit better, why don't we say enough with the chit-chat and cut to the chase, shall we? You can't keep bending over for your aunt, Michael. You have to show her how much you suffered at the loss of your father, but at the same time, get her back for all the years of your life that she's ruined.
I don't know. I don't really want to cause any more conflict than there already is.
Think about it, Michael. What do you have to lose? Your aunt already hates you. Your mom doubts you can even hold up a job, and who even cares what your brothers think? Only this house has even the smallest grain of respect for you.
Well, what do I do? What do I do to even begin to show them how much pain she's caused me?
There are many things in which you could do to get that expression across to her, Michael. But what I suggest is that you...
Should I be surprised?
What?
Well, aren't you just a waste of 2 billion years of evolution? I come in here to find you talking to yourself, and no progress has been made in this room since the last time I was here. What have you been doing?
Just collecting my thoughts.
Well, now that you're done with that, you should stop collecting dust and get to work. Hunter and James are going to be here any moment, and I want the house to be in tip-top shape for when they do arrive. You know they had the big game tonight, right? Oh, I cannot wait to find out how they did.
It's just a high school lacrosse game. How big a deal can it be?
You're just jealous.
Jealous? Jealous of what?
You envy your brothers because you wish you were them. It's simple. Because they're going places with their lives while you're just here.
Are James and Hunter here yet?
No, not yet, but they shouldn't be too much longer. I was just telling Michael here what he needed to get done for me as soon as possible. However, I think I'm wasting my breath because it seems as whatever I say just goes in one ear and out the other. I mean, look at him. He's still just standing there.
Mind your aunt.
But Mom, do you not remember the conversation?
Michael Clancy Freeman, do not talk back to me. Mind your Aunt Sharon. Now.
Children's days. You spend the first 2 years of their lives teaching them how to walk and talk, then you spend the next 16 teaching them how to sit down and shut up.
We're home!
Well, it's about time my 2 favorite all-stars got here. So, don't keep me waiting, boys. How'd the game go? You kicked butt, right?
Is that a rhetorical question, Sharon? You know we rocked them.
Yeah, no thanks to James' insane sock trick.
Woo!
Hey, you had some pretty sick goals yourself. Like that behind the back shot right before halftime. That was totally clutch.
Hey man, I don't think it beats you stealing the peanut butter at the top of the third.
Woo! I know, but that Canadian egg roll he made during the fourth sure does. Woo!
You boys and your silly lingo. So, what was the final score?
Complete blowout.
We annihilated them. 18-0.
My word! That's phenomenal, you guys. That certainly calls for a celebration. Don't you agree, Kayla?
Of course. You two must be starving, right?
I can munch tatties for days.
Then it's settled, then. I'm taking us out for a dinner celebration. Why don't you boys go put your things away upstairs and we'll be right on our way.
All right, Sharon.
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Sharon, I completely forgot about the cake. Help me decorate it before we leave.
Oh, why, of course.
Sometimes I feel worthless. Like no one even cares that I'm alive.
I'm missing a couple payments to the mafia. Definitely have certain people's attention then.
I guess, but sometimes I think I'd consider myself lucky if they just whacked me and ended it all now. I kind of figured. So what's wrong, Mike? My brothers, they're always making me look bad, worthless compared to them.
So you're jealous.
I guess you can say that.
Well, you shouldn't be. You're better than that, Michael. Don't let them walk all over you and have them tell you who they think you are. Be a man. Show them who's boss.
I guess you're right. But
And that's why you never, ever take a laxative and a sleeping pill in the same night.
You're so full of useful wisdom, Sharon.
Oh, my, thank you, dear.
You just saved me from my future self.
Oh, you're too
thank
sweet.
You.
So, where was it you boys wanted to go?
Anywhere you want to eat is fine with me.
Yeah, you always have great taste.
Oh. Okay, Michael, we're going out to dinner now.
Okay, hold on 1 second, I'll be right out.
And, what have you done today?
Oh, what a loser!
Oh, come on, boys.
Be back later.
The hell was that? I told you to be a man, not to grab your ankles and take whatever they dished out for you.
You saw what happened. I would have loved to have done something, but there was nothing I could do.
You had plenty of opportunities to take action. You just never seized the right moment.
Oh, yeah? And what did you do?
Ooh, ouch, Michael. That kind of hurt. But you better watch yourself. You're starting to sound a lot like your aunt. Hopefully she's not rubbing off on you or anything.
Don't be ridiculous.
I'm not. I'm just making a purely sensible observation.
You know, I think you better start watching yourself, or I might have
to... Or you what? Exactly, Michael. You'll do nothing, just like you have for the past 8 years.
You don't understand. It's not like I really have a choice.
But you have more options at your disposal than your youthful mind could even begin to grasp. You just need to ask yourself what you want.
What I want? Well, that's simple. You pretty much already laid it out for me. I want Aunt Sharon to know that she wasn't the only one to suffer at the expense of my father's death, and yet at the same time, get back at her for all the years of my life that she's ruined.
So think about it, Michael. What is the one thing that Sharon holds closest to her heart? It's the last thing that ties you captive to your past, tormenting you night after night. Think about it. That's right, Michael. Show her how much you suffered.
Thank you. just love the rush of adrenaline after a good show like that. Speechless, I see. Can all be a little overwhelming at first, but as a reassurance, I'll let you know that it does tend to grow on me. Care for a drag, Michael?
Everything's different. Except you. This isn't really what I was anticipating. I thought things would be different.
Different. And here I was thinking you'd be so happy to make this big change in your life, Michael, but you never really wanted to, did you? No. You were perfectly content with being walked all over by Sharon, isn't that right? You felt you deserved it for killing your father. See, your problem was never Sharon, it's yourself and the guilt you choose to live with every day. Choice, Michael. Make a choice. You can choose to go back and continue to choke on the guilt that suffocated you for all these years. But that's not what you want, is it? Hell, you don't even know what it is that you want anymore, isn't that right?
Yes.
But I do, Michael. See, I've been here all along. I know everything about you. Choose me, Michael. I can take you where you want to be. All you have to do is smash the urn.
I'm not really sure that I can trust you anymore.
Who else is there here for you to trust, Michael? You've fallen, and I'm offering you a hand. You know what you want.
Smash it!
Where am I?
Where you wanted to be all along, Michael. Alone.
I never said I wanted to be here. You tricked me into coming here. You told me to smash the urn.
You? Me? What's the difference, Michael? All that matters now is you're alone. You gave in to temptation, and now it's up to you to find your own way out. You can't run away from your problems,